Whoop. He's dead. Probably the guy ran half of the map just to die like this.
Oh, hello, mister. Hello. Thank you for the ash val. Hello.
Listen closely. This nasty construction worker wants me to murder 15 people for him. And in exchange, he gives me almost nothing. And on top of that, he has a weird fetish and wants me to wear a unushanka and my grandpa's vest. Should I accept it? Yes. With this nasty gear, everybody will think I'm a scav. So basically, I'm doing a scav cosplay. Since it's the late wipe, we'll struggle against the big chat. So maybe camping a little bit and playing it slow will give me a chance to win. There is no way I can kill people now. I don't even have the bullets. Oh! People actually fighting around. I might just sneak and tap in the head and just run. Maybe. They are coming close. Oh! They are fighting right here in front of me. Oh! I killed him, but there's one more on the left and one more in the back there. I know what you're thinking. Come on, you're a noob. Instead of pushing, you just waited in the bush for 15 more minutes for the players to come back. So what? I was more invisible than your sex life is. Nobody knew where I was. I was like a baby tortoise camouflaging into the sand, waiting for the eagle to pass by. But instead of running into the water, I was just going to shoot the eagle between his eyes. Oh, he's slowly approaching. Oh, he's the guy who just fought with this guy that I just murdered. Oh, I bet you feel stupid now. Little boy. Everything was quite simple. I stay under a rock and when someone comes to my buddies, I stand up and shoot them. Basically, I'm a certified professional gangster who is looking over the block. What's up with this slang? I have no idea. I can't even understand half of the words I'm saying. Ooh, footsteps. I wonder, is it a scav? A player scav? Or a PMC? Oh, it's a PMC.
Everybody makes mistakes. Because no one can be perfect.
Poor guy. Was it me or he moaned when I put a bullet inside his head? Maybe he was just a little bit horny. But still weird as fuck. I don't even feel bad, he was a weak sperm. A weak sperm always go through the bodies before checking properly around. And of course, after about 5 seconds, I stood up and went through the bodies without properly checking around. I mean, it's not like a guy sitting in a bush waiting for me to approach his body and then shooting me with a 12 gauge in the head. Oh, yo. Is it the nasty sniper scav? It's the nasty sniper scav. Man, he's fucking camping the bodies. Too bad I'm too good at this game. He wished. After looting the other bodies and touching them a little bit more than I intended, I got concerned about my sexuality. Because I didn't know anymore if I was gay or necrophiliac. And decided to just run out, to avoid further questions. I mean, this raid was pretty good. I got myself a nice DMR! No. Oh, thank god that sniper sucks. You know, the bad thing about this mission is that I have to wait 4 hours in order to craft some bullets so I can have the smallest chance to kill other players. So what should I do meanwhile? I mean, I can take a shit, masturbate, and hit the gym. Basically, this is what all the male population is doing. Since I had a lot of great success on construction, I decided to go there again in order to catch some poor people off guard who just tried to enjoy their evening by playing some Tarkov after work. Ooh! That was lucky. Now I have one more guy to go. Man. Maybe I didn't stay on the phone. I could have killed them earlier. Both of them look pretty juicy in my eyes. So I need to be extra careful and not miss my shots. I think I'm dead. Man, this guy is so weak sperm. I can't believe he repeated the same spot 4 times. I was very excited about my loot. I felt like a teenager who just discovered the incognito tab on the browser. But then, all my joy was taken away in a matter of seconds. And I felt just like a teenager who discovered incognito tab, but forgot to disconnect from the home speakers. In my head, I thought my plan to stay there was great, but I figured it out very fast that I was just lucky. After a naked guy with a pistol absolutely destroyed me. So I decided to travel far away from that place, probably like 50 meters far away, and stay in a bush for hours. There's a few footsteps I hear around. Here they are, two guys. Yeah. Man, I feel so bad and disgusted by myself, but also I feel so good. After those two kills, I stayed in the bush the whole morning, but unfortunately, nobody came across. I went towards the bodies while laying on the ground just to imagine how it is to be an insect. I was pretty bored after waiting in the bush. I also may have touched the guy's corpse a little bit inappropriate, but who is there to complain? The loot was good, but I had no space to carry it and decided to call it a day. On my way out, I also found a 2-year-old juice hidden in the underground container. The intrusive thoughts won this time and I had to chuck the whole bottle. I had to take a small break on the train tracks after I drank that, and I heard a weird noise right behind me. That was quite smooth, I hope it was a player. Fortunately, it was a player and I ruined somebody else's day. My progress was up and I just had to make a few more kills before I can finally finish this quest and go to sleep. And because of my spawn, I decided to stay around Stronghold and Olga Station this raid. Oh yo yo, what a crazy mountain goat we have here. Come to daddy mo, baby. Man, I don't know how I missed, like, 4 shots. Thank god I hit him. But I really need to work on my aim. Oh, who is a useless dead body on the ground? You are. Okay, go back. While I was scouting the area, I saw a scav hanging around and I said, come on, why not you exercise your aim? It's not like you're going to miss him 30 times and waste all of your bullets. And after I finally killed him, I felt more disgusted of myself. I couldn't even hit a standing target. And just imagine, I've been playing video games for a lot of years now, this is all I do. It felt like I was a chef in a big Michelin restaurant and I just turned in a medium rare chicken breast. I was a big disappointment. And of course after 5 seconds a duo came and killed me. I was left only 2 kills, but I had too little rubble to do it. So I had to take a stock shotgun and fulfill my dream of making the cranky construction worker happy for once in his life of building walls and carrying bricks. I couldn't let him down. Man, that scav is not stupid, he heard something. And that something might be right here. Or he's just schizophrenic. We'll never know. They're fighting right here. Oh! La la! Okay, I need one more kill. Eventually, I'll kill the guy who wanted to kill this guy. Sounds like a deal. I know I love it from behind, but not this time when somebody's in crack house. Ah, it's a scare. It was wonderful, but I made a lot of noise and probably somebody will come here and kill me. Or maybe not. Oh, yo, nades. Nades. Ah, he's in the crack house. Oh, okay. He's juicy as well. It seems like he closed the door, so he's not up there anymore. He might go from behind or from in front, if my headset is not turned backwards. Yo, he's so thick. I think he's more scared than I am. He can lose everything and I can lose my shotgun. Even though I love my shotgun.
It would be such a shame for you to lose everything and I have a stock shotgun.
This is how I make him go crazy, you know? Listen to this. This guy is more hurt than a 14-year-old girl after a breakup. He has no chance.
Ooh, somebody's behind me. But I did the quest, I don't care.
Oh, I just fell to the ground. I must have tripped. I didn't even care I died. I was happy because that quest was finally over. This was pretty much it for today. Thank you for watching the video and I want to thank my patrons for helping me buy booze every month. Peterska, Paul Diaz, Shashish, Nox, Danny Bass, I'm Maple, Starchy and Tickle Mielmo. Thank you so much guys and wish you all a great success.